What is fire? Fire is a rapid exothermic chemical reaction of a fuel with oxygen. A reaction with oxygen is also referred to as oxidation in chemistry. Exothermic means that heat is released during the reaction. We only speak of combustion or fire in the case of rapid oxidations. There are also slow oxidations, for example, the process of iron rusting. Flame and glow. The heat released during combustion creates a flame through the emission of light from the combustion gases. Electrons of the heated particles temporarily reach a higher energy level and fall back to their original energy levels after a short time, releasing energy in the form of a light quantum. We refer to the burning and light-emitting gas or vapor stream as a flame. With solid substances, there is also the phenomenon of glow. Glow is the light emission of a solid substance heated to a high temperature. Glow thus only occurs during the combustion of solid substances. Some fuels burn without glow, so only with a flame. These include liquid substances after transitioning into gas form, gaseous substances, solid substances that evaporate when heated. In the reaction zone, the actual process of combustion occurs, which is the chemical connection between fuel and oxygen with the release of heat. In the case of solid fires, the reaction zone can be identified by the glow. The flame zone contains hot combustion gases and sometimes unburnt fuel. The heat leads to light emission, as mentioned above. Due to unburnt fuels, oxidation reactions can still occur here. In the gas or buoyant zone, no flame is visible anymore. Here, the combustion products and partially unburned gaseous fuels rise due to their high temperature. Visually, the buoyant zone is mostly recognized as smoke. Conditions of combustion. The conditions under which combustion can occur are described by the five pillars of combustion. To ignite a fire, certain conditions must be met. There must be a mixture of fuel vapor and air in the correct ratio. The material must be heated to a temperature at which combustion can occur, the so-called ignition temperature. Once the fire is burning, it gives off heat and provides the activation energy for further combustion itself. A chain reaction occurs, eliminating the need for additional energy input. In the English-speaking world and in maritime shipping, instructors have often used the fire triangle in the past to represent combustion. The fire triangle consists of three factors: fuel, heat, and oxygen. Nowadays, a fourth factor is mostly considered: the presence of an unimpeded chemical chain reaction. This approach is known as the fire tetrahedron. The fuel can be in the form of a solid, liquid, or gas, and combines with oxygen during the oxidizing chemical reaction. When the fuel reaches a sufficiently high temperature and an oxidizing agent is present, it ignites, leading to combustion. The ignition point or ignition temperature is the temperature at which a flammable substance, solid, liquid, its vapors, or gas, must be heated so that it self-ignites in the presence of oxygen solely due to its temperature, thus without an additional ignition source like a spark. It varies for each substance and is dependent on several factors like pressure, fuel volume, and fuel geometry. The minimum combustion temperature is the lowest temperature a fuel must reach to maintain self-sustaining combustion without external energy input. At this temperature, just enough heat is released that, after the heat losses to the environment are accounted for, enough fuel can be thermally processed by pyrolysis, evaporation, or sublimation, and ignited to maintain the combustion process. If the temperature of the fire drops below the minimum combustion temperature, the combustion process comes to a halt. Solid fuels, such as wood, cannot burn in their solid state. Instead, the heat causes the solid material to decompose and produce flammable gases that then ignite. This process is called pyrolysis. The solid fuel only burns when enough pyrolysis gases are produced. You can observe this effect when trying to set a piece of wood on fire. You have to heat the fuel for a certain period before it catches fire. Heat. A self-sustaining combustion reaction of solids and liquids depends on radiation feedback. The fire itself provides heat energy for the continued vapor generation to maintain combustion. If the fire generates enough heat to maintain or amplify this feedback, the fire either remains constant or grows, depending on the heat produced. A positive heat balance occurs when the fire returns heat to the fuel. A positive heat balance is necessary to sustain combustion. If the heat is dissipated faster than it is generated, the heat balance is negative. This is why we can extinguish a fire by cooling the fuel. Chemical chain reaction. A chain reaction is a series of reactions that occur in succession, with the results of each individual reaction adding to the others. When heating a fuel, vapors can form that contain substances that combine with oxygen and burn. Once combustion has started, it can only continue if enough heat energy is generated to cause the further development of fuel vapors. The self-sustaining chemical reaction and the associated rapid growth are the factors that distinguish fire from slower oxidation reactions. Oxygen. Normally, the oxidizing agent is the oxygen in the air surrounding the fuel. However, some substances, like sodium nitrate and potassium chlorate, release their own oxygen during combustion, meaning these fuels can burn even in an oxygen-free atmosphere. The amount of oxygen available for combustion is crucial. As previously mentioned, air under normal circumstances contains about 21% oxygen. Oxygen concentrations below the normal 21% adversely affect combustion. The intensity of a fire begins to decrease below an oxygen concentration of 18%. Oxygen concentrations below 15% do not support combustion. The fire suffocates. Understanding these factors of a fire will be important later to explain the extinguishing effect of various extinguishing agents such as water, foam, dry powder, or carbon dioxide, as well as to understand firefighting tactics.